Yo, what's good, y'all? What's good? Welcome to the channel, y'all. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Now, if you guys did not know, today is actually my birthday. I'm officially the big 2-0. You heard? I'm out of my teen years. Y'all can call me grown now. For sure. For sure, ski. Okay? Jenna Ortega hit my line. Or Madelyn Cline can. Her, she and Chase weren't together anymore. No, that's not a good thing. On a serious note, I definitely have a lot of Outer Banks reactions to do, and I definitely enjoyed this third season. I actually thought the third season was the best season out of all three. It was my favorite. I felt like it was just, I don't know, like, I loved it. How did you guys like it? Like, was it one of your favorites, or was it maybe your least favorite? And tell me why. Who was your favorite character this season? I can honestly say that Cleo is the MVP for me, okay? She's my favorite character. Point blank, period, okay? Hashtag no love club. Well, no longer that, but won't spoil too much, you know. But hey, so we're gonna be getting into a video requested by a VIP patron. This is requested by Haley. So thank you, Haley. I really appreciate it. Haley has two other requests that I will be getting to right after this. But this is gonna be Outer Banks star Madelyn Cline's hometown guide to Charleston. Yeah, so I'm gonna like the video. Please make sure you guys like this video up. Like it up, like it up, like it up, man. Let's get into it. Let me get over here and my homie, let's get it.
The first stop
She's so
when we
fine.
get to Charleston is we are stopping and getting a sweet tea immediately. Hi, I'm
Sweet
Madelyn Cline,
tea.
and I'm going to personally show you around Charleston. Let's go.
That's pretty
What makes
cool.
Charleston a special place for me, for starters? I am from there, so it is home. I'm from about 30 minutes outside of it. My family is still there. So when we go shoot Outer Banks, we shoot in Charleston, I get to see my family. So there's a lot of really special memories wrapped up in that city. If I were gonna take you for coffee in Charleston, I would first take you to the Daily. That is my absolute favorite spot in Charleston to get coffee.
Let
We
me take
know
notes.
everybody there. They're always so friendly. They make their almond milk in-house, and they do an incredible avocado toast. The
Hold on,
food is
hold on,
amazing.
hold on now, hold on now. We're going a little too fast. The
For
best
coffee in
coffee.
Charleston,
I
I
don't really drink
would
coffee,
first
but
take
you
you
have to
to the
go.
Daily. That is my absolute favorite
The
spot in
Daily.
Charleston to get coffee. I know everybody there. They're always so friendly. They make their almond milk in-house, and they do an incredible avocado toast. The food is amazing. These are Benny wafers, and they're made with, I think it's like a lot of, I'm not sure how to make them, but I know they're special because they have sesame seeds in them. And they're kind of salty, super crispy. They're like the Charleston cookie. Also not pictured. Get you some okra candy. That's like final
Looks more
boss
like
of
a
Charleston sweets.
cracker.
And then there's also, these are pralines. I don't know why they're special, other than they just taste great. They're like
I don't like nuts.
super
See,
lovely,
Madeline,
super spicy.
we don't
You can
see eye to
find these
eye.
things
I'm breaking up with
literally
you.
everywhere. They are signatures of Charleston.
Sweet tea is bomb, though. I like a good sweet
You
tea.
always have to do your lemon. This is not really graceful. Laughs maniacally. Give it a good stir. Sweet tea is not sweet tea if there's not a little lemon in it.
I beg to differ.
Delicious. You can get this anywhere. It's not just a Charleston staple, it's a Southern staple. I also love that y'all put it in a mason jar. That's so cute. And then we also, when you order half and half, it's like half sweet, half unsweet. I remember the first time I ordered half and half, I think I was in New York, and they came with like a half and half, like what you put in your coffee, like dairy product. And I understood why they looked at me so strange, because I was asking for just straight half and half. It just tastes like home. I have been known
I like
to
all
be
sweet.
late for work because I was stuck in traffic in the drive-thru to get a sweet tea. I'm gonna get in trouble for that. No one's taking this. Yes. Everybody has their own opinions. Oysters, that's a very personal experience. However, if I'm taking you to get the best oysters, I'm taking you to Leon's Oysters and Poultry. Basically, it's fried chicken and oysters, which I don't think you can get more southern than that. They have the best oysters,
Leon's.
the best fried chicken, and the best orange wine. which for me is a successful dinner. It's salt, starch, butter, and sweet tea. Those are the four pillars of a Southern diet. I don't really go out in Charleston too much, but if I'm really feeling like ripping, I would probably take you to El Jefe because there's a mechanical bowl. Mechanical bowl is just like a recipe for a great night. And then at that point, anywhere sounds fun. Enough tequila, we could go anywhere. We could go to Trio. We could go to Republic. We could go skinny dipping. We could go to Folly Beach and skinny dip. I think that's illegal.
Folly Beach.
My friends and I, when I was in high school, we used to have this little place at the very, very end of Folly Beach. There's this little clearing.
Skinny dipping.
The grass. And we would set up a little fire, and then we would go and shoot Roman candles at each other. That's my kind of night. If you're going to go shopping in Charleston, you know what's really fun is they shut down King Street, and so you can walk in the middle of the road, and there's everybody's out with their dogs, and there's vendors. And one of my favorite vendors, Red Rose Vintage, she has like a little truck, and she has vintage that comes through all the time, and she has some really cool pieces, and I love that it's in like a little van. I've given her a lot of my money. There's a really great shop called Worthwhile that has very curated, cool, like candles, clothes made by like small designers, local designers. Really, really cool place. That's one of my favorite places in Charleston. To see the most beautiful sunset, I would take you to Shem Creek, which is in Mount Pleasant. There are restaurants literally on Shem Creek, and you can sit and watch the sunset and have a beer, or get bottomless crab legs, or eat oysters. Up to you. Beautiful, usually because the fishing boats are coming in, there's dolphins, so you can see dolphins in the creek. It's very, very postcard-like.
That's fine.
Less touristy. The old village in Mount Pleasant is really picturesque and beautiful. We shoot there quite a bit. It's really, really lovely. People just on their bikes or walking their dogs. Isle of Palms is great. It is touristy, but also, again, they have an amazing strip of restaurants. They've got a really great place called Poe's, with like sandwiches. The next one, which is tacos. I can't remember the place, but they have a frozen rosé. You can just go to the beach, get your rosé, and just sit there and let your mind go.
Damn, is he gone?
I did grow up going to some theaters in the area. I used to go see the ballet a lot with my mom. There's a very small theater, and the company is called the Flower Town Players. That was where I did my very first play that wasn't a school play. There's another theater downtown called Theater 99, and that's like Charleston's improv troupe theater. That's definitely a like, very locals activity and hilarious. And that was kind of where I got that spark for theater again. It was just so much fun and very freeing. It's a great little place to go. Get tickets online in advance. They sell out quick. Charleston is tiny. It is an extremely small world, but also the people are incredibly warm and friendly, and that's always really lovely to come back to. I love getting on a plane to go back home and hearing the pilot come over the speaker and be like, "Hey y'all," with a Southern accent, and greet everyone. Sparks joy.
Hey y'all.
Just talking about Charleston gets me really excited, and I hope you guys want to go check it out for yourself.
I'm definitely checking it out now, okay? I got family in Charleston, but I'm gonna go for real now. I'm gonna go for me now. Okay, I got a whole bunch of places now written down. I got a whole bunch of places. I got Poe's Tavern. I'm not gonna read them all out. I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I got 8 places from Madelyn. Like, thank you, girl. Thank you. This is a great video, you guys. I really, really enjoyed it. Honestly, I love traveling, so this was a great video for me specifically. And of course, knowing that this amazing actress likes all these spots just makes it even better, okay? So I'm definitely going to have to do a traveling vlog when I go there and literally hit these spots that Madelyn's talking about, kind of make a vlog about it. I think that would be really interesting for you guys. But thank you guys so much for watching. Stay tuned, because I do have other Outer Banks interviews and challenge reactions to react to. So, challenge videos to react to. Okay? Stay tuned and stay litty. Yeah.